The internet is a whole world of information. You can find nearly anything out there. Although, sometimes it takes some digging. But you might be surprised to know how much information is out there about you. And who might be doing some digging of their own. We all give bits of information about ourselves to the internet every day. Usernames, search terms, where we click on screen are called passive data. And there's plenty more that we leave behind as we go about our travels, without even realizing it. We're nearly always being tracked. You've probably been asked on websites if you will accept a cookie and clicked the yes button without thinking too much about it. While they have a delicious name, these cookies are creepier than the real thing. A cookie is a small text file stored on your device by your web browser when you visit a site on the internet. It is used to collect your passive data. Websites need cookies to remember useful bits of information, like whether you're logged in or preferences you've set up. Without cookies, this information would be forgotten between visits to the site. Each cookie contains a name, a value, and attributes, the useful information the cookie stores. Code embedded in websites can write cookies and read ones left from previous visits. Cookies are labeled with the website that created them, and only that site can read them. But most sites include ads or content that come from somewhere else. This can let other companies store cookies without you visiting their site directly. And a website can have dozens of these third-party cookies. Because the companies can read those cookies via multiple websites, they can use them to track where you go. Since the introduction of new privacy laws, in some countries, many websites have to tell you they're storing cookies, as well as who they are for and what they are for, and ask you if that's okay. But most store so many that we rarely read the detailed information about them. Many web browsers now block third-party cookies, but a website can still share information stored in its own first-party cookies with third-party companies. And even without cookies, there's plenty of information your browser provides that can be collected. Things like your IP address, which can be used to figure out where you are in the world, information about the device and software you're using. And even, through a variety of tricks, whether you are logged into social media services. Although they don't know who you are, companies can put all this information together into a digital fingerprint that identifies you from other users. They can use the fingerprint to work out you're the same person across multiple websites, even after their original cookie has expired. Since one of these companies might have ads on lots of websites you visit, the company's server can access the same cookie via all of them. This allows them to build a list of sites you visit, tracking you across the internet. Over time, tracking companies gather more and more information about you and use it to guess things like your gender, age, and specific interests. Most tracking companies do this to target the kinds of people they think will like the products their clients are trying to sell. And this is kind of okay for us. We'd probably rather see ads about things we might like than ones of random stuff. But as tracking companies share more and more information with each other, they might learn enough about us to do things other than just show us ads. But it's not just passive data and tracking we should be thinking about. We're constantly being asked to make accounts for social media and other online services that ask for our name, date of birth, gender, email address, real-world location, and we give it to them. Services like Instagram and Facebook know even more about us. Who our friends and family are, where we go to school and work, our relationship status, the kinds of interests we have. Every interaction is tracked, from where we click a link to how long we pause when we scroll, teaching them about who we interact with, what we like to do, and how long we like to spend doing it. Uploaded photos can include a wealth of information, where the photo was taken, what kind of phone or camera took it, and even if we use the tagging options, who's in them. These features are also what make apps like Instagram and Facebook useful to us in the first place, keeping track of our friends and relatives and letting them do the same to us. These services are free to us, but they make money by charging companies for the ads that target us, or by letting music, dating, and other apps use your Facebook information as a shortcut so they don't have to ask for it themselves. All of this data creates a digital footprint you leave behind on the internet.
If you liked this video, you can find it and so many more at ClickView.net. Sign up for free today.